So I will just begin because it's already really late now. So good evening, Prashanta sir and Mr. Galaxy Tab A. Thanks for joining in. Today I, Samriddhi Mandavar, feel proud to host this very special webinar on tribute to Srimati Kamini Roy. But before that, I have a very interesting story to share, a story about my family, a story about my belief in a society where both men and women are treated equally. So like it goes back fairly 40, 41 years back when one of my father's sister was planning to get a divorce and the entire family was not supporting her. But it was my father who stepped in and then he just said, see, you've been financially dependent all your life. Now it is time that to step up, pursue a degree and be financially independent. Years later, when I went to meet her for the very first time when I was 13 or 14, I was very amazed that she was then serving as the general manager at Hitachi. So I just went and I was like, Bua, how do you do so well for yourself and your two children? And she just said one thing, and that was, women are financially dependent and therefore they are emotionally caged. And that was when she also recommended me a work called Malya O Nirmalya by Kamini Roy. And that's how my association with the works of Kamini Roy can be traced back to. So today, like as I start and pay her some tribute, I'll just share a few information about Srimati Kamini Roy ji. Like, she has been the most influential feminist writers of the then British India, and she was the first woman honors graduate of colonial India. She was born in now Jharkhand, and she's been Bengali, and she's been very powerful with her issues on women, as we all know that feminist voices are a voice so strong and forceful that it literally shook the entire establishment of the hijab, this establishment across different stratas. And her notable works are Mahashweta, Malya O Nirmalya, Aloe Chaya. And because not much of her works are available in translated form, she remains the unsung hero and an inaccessible author in the Indian literature industry. I would like to share a poem written by her, which is very close to my heart, and that was translated by Srimati Nirmala Vyas. She's graduate from Delhi University and was head of English Literature Department there at the University of Delhi. And the poem is In Silence. Like a fortress, sadness filled, not even washed away by the tireless flow of teardrops. How much pain resides in the dense, hard snow that can never be melted by tears. Numerous arrows face I in the crowd, poverty stricken, cheerless men and women roar. Thinking when in the peaceful nest in the twilight of darkness, forever will sleep men that live in the constant pain. You and I do not have songs of rue. When the feet is pricked with thorns, eyes the moist. We do not bear the stones of despair beyond words inextinguishable in fire. Silent lips, eyes are blurred. On the forehead, profound peace, similar to death. Not once or twice, but thrice staring, aloof in silence, offer your tears to him. Offer your tears to him. I know this is on a very dark tangent of the issue that is domestic violence and the tears that the person, the victim, actually has. I have her second work, and that is As the Days Pass. As the days pass, darkness overwhelms me. I see not the divine light, hear not the oracle. Childhood fancies, dreams I think were all countless. All those yearn to believe as truth of many present condition. All those yearn to believe as truth of my present condition, like many others. I too move, meet calls. Oh, what feel, I hope. How noble could I do that, but awaken to fetters in my hand. Cruel inability seizes this life, unceasingly overpowers. Not a drop of strength to combat the wailing pain. In my heart, hopelessness resides. In the anterior, depressing sides, wrote, stopping flowing tears, sighs, lament, laugh when the world laughs, but that was impossible. This constant self-oblivion, what arcane warmth keeps me awakened underneath the ocean's waves. As hot current within the secret chambers, beneath the calmness and felicity of life, the river of despair streams perpetual. So these were two of my favorites work by her, and luckily the translated versions were now were then taken over by Vyoga Books International Limited. It is a publishing house mostly famous for all the Nobel laureates who have published so far. Vyoga has also published all the works by Rabindranath Tagore, and you can find the at Gandhi Ashram. They also have their bookstore. So yeah, I'm not promoting them. I'm just sharing across the information that I have about them. So when I actually was introduced to Kamini Roy Ji and the influence that she placed on me, I was also able to write certain things, and based on the influence that she has placed on me and the things that I read then by Kamala Das and Kusum Chopra and many such feminist writers, I also gave certain words to my thoughts in my book called Unobliterated Unspoken Emotions. So this is my book, and I'll be reciting two poems on the same grounds which Srimati Kamini Roy Ji wrote. So first one is Dilemma. Hey girl, are you ready to rise? The unblown candles on my cake question. As I blew them, I also realized the material world shall never gift me the paradise. Utterance of desires and gasoline, I pursed my lips and blew out tongues of flame, a presage of future which is supposed to be wholly mine. And that. So this is one poetry from my book. And the other one is called Prostitutiveness, that is the business of prostitution and how prostitutes are overlooked and underlooked at the same time. So this is written in Hindi, and it was also published in the Hindustan Times. The English newspaper to publish a Hindi poem for the very first time. Log dimag ka sauda karte hain, unhe vyapari bulaya jata hai. Main apne sharir ka aur mujhe vyapar karne wali. Kismat ka khel hai ye, ki main vyapari nahi, vyapar karne wali hu. Aur insaan ka khel dekhiye. जो व्यापारी हैं वे ही मेरा व्यापार कर रहे हैं। दिमाग और बुद्धि शरीर के हिस्से हैं। मुझे जलील करना, इज्जत ना बख्शना, तिरछी नजरों से देखना मेरी जीवन के अतरंगे किस्से हैं। विडंबना देखिए, व्यापारी व्यापार बढ़ाने लोगों तक जाता है। अब सुनिए, मंदिर और मेरा व्यापार एक साथ है। लोग सामने से आते हैं और पैसा भी दे जाते हैं, फिर भी मेरा मंदिर में आना लोगों को खटकता है। मैं व्यापार करने वाली नहीं, अभी तो व्यापारी ही हूँ। आप सभी के इज्जत व स्वीकृति की भागीदार हूँ। सो दिस इज द सेकंड पोएम, the one which we all are going through, the last one which we all are going through at the moment because of the Hathras case that just recently happened, that is on rapes. Rapes in my country, terror in my mind. Although my vagina bleeds, but not more than my eyes. Oh, my brothers, making love is immortal. But having an unconsented sex, the diaper baby said, I know nothing at all. Of the misogynistic perception, mothers or wives are to an extent helpless. And we have a choice to give our sisters and daughters an environment over duress. Rapes in my country, terror in my mind. Although my vagina bleeds, but not more than my eyes. Every girl has a dream of her perfect wedding, but dislodging her dignity over a crime willingly shall disintegrate her soul in entirety. And to cover up domestic violence, she, only in the name of happy marriage, lost her virginity. The requirement is to kill the mindsets of the criminals, be it girl or a boy. But the requirement is just to kill the mindsets of the criminals. Educating our sons and empowering our daughters seems a concrete decision. Rapes in my country should just remain a history. Let my vagina bleed, for my eyes should shine for such a phenomenal victory. So yeah, that's it for today. Thank you so much for joining in, and I just hope over the years, as we celebrate 156th birth anniversary of Srimati Kamini Roy. We also celebrate Kamala Das. We also celebrate Kusum Chopra. We also celebrate other women authors who have been making histories, Sarojini Naidu ji and everyone. Thank you so much for joining me. I, somebody in heaven, take your blessings for further things. Thank you.